We are live. Scoot your chair back, fuck.
Hey, look, y'all said that. Yeah. I didn't say
shit. Shut up, bro. Shit. I don't know what the fuck is going on, but this shit is about to piss me off. So you know what? I'm just coming down, so, download the audio off the video.
So you got a virus.
I got a virus. Some of the security that's like blocking all my fucking apps from going. But anyway.
You got the engineer right here.
Nigga, I know, right?
Right now,
motherfucker, we live right now. We to their bullshit.
Right now. Live in this bag.
Yeah. Everybody share that shit.
Oh, yeah, let me turn that shit off, too. Fucking call. Like always. I don't know what you're talking about, man.
Betty says she's enjoying the show.
Who?
Betty's like,
hi, Rachel. Hey,
up,
Betty.
Rachel.
Hey, Roslyn.
Hey, Rosy Dazzy.
Who?
Roslyn Doslin.
Who? Energy up.
Hey.
Woo!
Take a shot.
Yes, there it is.
Take a shot for me.
Mic check.
One, two.
What is this? Bitch, I'm by the bar and we back in business.
Plus, I miss.
Everybody already know. What's up? It is episode 7.
7 of them.
I'm for sure. Don't quote me on that. I will change it later if it's wrong.
An asterisk.
But for right now, it's episode 7 of Bitchin' by the Bar. I am your host with the most, the blessed and highly favored Frank with a pen, here with some of my
esteemed colleagues.
hyper associates.
Oh, hyper. Oh, I think we step up from last week.
We got Kendall B in the place to be.
Kendall
B. Nah, hell no.
Marky D.
Marky D, a.k.a. Marcus 800. Find me on everything.
And we got Wayne Gibson in. Oh, OnlyFans. Yes.
Whoa.
Yeah. Forever, nigga.
That's going to force me to be that porno friend. All right.
$15.99 a month.
Hold on, nigga. You extremely overpriced yourself. $15.99?
Nigga, I'm more than that. Hey, man, look, he got 2 subscribers. You get that $31.
Get the fuck out of here.
It's giving her down.
It's full-blown professionals. They should be like $3.99 just to get you in there, because they know once you see them naked, you're going to be throwing that cash at them. But you think yours is worth $15.99.
$15.99.
I did a lot of groundwork in my life.
Get the fuck out of here.
I did the whole witness route from door to door.
Oh, you a door to door hoer?
At the end of the day, we all was.
Wait, what? We.
I am not a part of whatever debauchery you are assuming of.
Yeah, because this devil is some debaucherist.
All right, Valentine's Day wasn't that long ago. I said I was going to bring it up next time we was on here. We was talking about it. What did everybody do for Valentine's Day? Starting off with the married nigga.
What did we do? Absolutely nothing. Chilled in the house.
Sweet Jesus.
We relaxed.
Sweet baby Jesus.
We celebrate Valentine's Day, but not on Valentine's Day because
that's all right.
It's too fucking busy.
We called and we tried to order food. Our food order didn't go through. That's how bad it was. We called 3 hours in advance and the shit. Wow. I was like, nope. So we gonna do something this weekend. So that's what we did. We did nothing.
So y'all celebrating a week later?
Yeah. I don't know. When y'all get to a certain point, it's like, nah, fuck these motherfuckers. That's with COVID. Everything was shut down.
They've been married 33 years.
Right. Just the simple fact that, you know, COVID shut it down. 25% capacity, and you trying to do a whole bunch of shit. Get out of here with that.
That's disappointing. I'm switching over to the dude with a girlfriend, a fiance.
Fiance. Don't you know?
What did you do for Valentine's Day? I saw it on Facebook, and I want you to give us the layout. What happened?
Exactly.
Well, the layout was real simple. You know, we simple folks.
What up, Annie?
We stayed at home, sent the kids away. Give what we knew. We set up the dining room like we was eating out, real fancy, a little wine, chocolate strawberries, some food, home cooked food by us, and watched the movie. Shout out to Judas and the Black Messiah.
First of all, that movie was half inspiring, half. If you already had trust issues, solidified your trust issues.
Look here, shout out to my boy Lakeith. I love him, but he was pissing me off through that whole movie.
Really, you really
hate you? You so good.
Oh, you so good.
Like, come here. Hold on, we gotta watch that because it's a list of actors that be playing their role so good that you hate them in real life. Let's not put him. He got a whole name.
He always.
That nigga got a whole name. And don't nobody know.
Just know this. Tekashi 6ix9ine is somewhere pissed because he thought he was supposed to play that role.
You got it in real life.
Oh my god!
Yeah, let it marinate.
Mm-hmm. Jesus Christ! I saw her status and shit. Talk about she woke up having a bad day. That's some female shit. Said she woke up having a bad day, but my baby made it all right and shit. I was like, all right, doing all right.
He knows what makes his girl happy. That's all
right. Simple things, right? When the kids are
simple things. Or, yeah, did you hear that? It's the simple things.
She's not
like,
old.
Like, no, nah, right, nah, written out in the aquarium.
Oh, no.
But here we go. That's a
different tag. Oh, Beyonce, you're here. Oh, she is here. Beyonce's internet? That's what we do.
That's simple things.
That ain't the simple.
It's the simple things like getting a phone number.
Yeah,
it's a long story. No, we're not going to go into. But she knows what I'm talking about.
Now we gonna toss it over to Mark, the
single. No, I'm gonna go last.
No, you gonna go last.
You can't go last. We gotta switch it up. We went married, engaged,
single. No, single should be last.
Yeah, single should be last. All right, we'll single last. All right, I'll let you slide on this one. On my end, it wasn't Valentine's Day. It was Valentine's weekend.
Okay, splurge, dead big baller.
We started off with some breakfast.
Mm. Oh, he said a real sensual.
Yeah,
started off with some breakfast. Some crazy breakfast in the head. Wait, how that song go?
I wish. Shout out to all the men who girls on their period Valentine's weekend.
Ooh, left them red.
I see what you did there, sir.
Bang bang.
Yeah, we saw us. We started off with some breakfast. I took her to Great Lakes Crossing. That's small.
Okay.
I just.
Did you rent it out?
No, bitch.
She ain't without sea light.
Hold on.
She was a Michael B. Jordan. You know, rent it out a whole aquarium.
Whole aquarium.
No, I was just like, you know what I'm saying? I don't know what, I'm terrible at buying females gifts. So I'm all like, I'm just going to take it to Great Lakes Crossing and let you get whatever you want to.
What? You're terrible.
Her most expensive, nigga, we passed by this store that sells Pandora shit. Ball on the floor. I got her a bunch of shit that she liked. She was very happy. And I got her some clothes. I wanted to get her some boots and shit, which she complained about today.
Another story.
A whole another story and shit. But yeah, we was just like ready to cross them. You know what I'm saying? Basically having a good time, looking at all the couples and shit, basically having the same train of thought that I have. Mind your ass, don't care. If you go to money, they'll get you.
Be happy.
Right. I'm trying to figure this shit out.
Don't come back with no change.
Pretty much. Then we left there. Now, I always get Ann Arbor and Auburn Hills confused.
Where did you go? Like, what places?
The place that I wanted to go was in Ann Arbor, which okay. I thought was Auburn Hills.
Oh.
Let me get a try.
No, I didn't.
It reminds real bad.
The street that has like a whole bunch of close to 5-star restaurants and shit. Yeah, that she loved all the restaurants. It's Big Beaver.
Yeah, Big Beaver. Oh,
yeah. Yeah. It's a truck.
Oh, yeah.
Nigga,
right.
I was like, it's Valentine's Day.
Real Chris.
I'm like, it's Valentine's Day. She won't. So we went to this place called Eddie V's.
Oh, yeah. Eddie V's.
Best decision
I've ever made. What did that bitch?
And they cook the
first
food.
Of all,
I thought y'all didn't go to the
hell.
Crab.
It's like Hell's Kitchen, dog. They cook the food.
God damn.
They go to the kitchen. You can see them cooking the food and shit.
Black on.
This wasn't that situation. Calm down.
It is.
First of all, since it was Valentine's Day, and so we went there before 8 o'clock, which is prime romantic hour and shit. We went in there about. It was almost 7 and shit, but we got in there quick, nigga. As soon as we walked in, they handed her a rose of champagne. They gave me a glass of champagne, which I pretended to drink to my mask and shit.
What's this vintage?
It was just getting dark, so the lighting outside was right. Plus the mood inside was right. We was right near the bar, which is they bar had shit that I've never even seen ever.
It had different types of orange soda for you.
Nick Kitty said,
"Don't drink."
Now y'all know he only
diet coke. I poured my champagne into her glass. What the fuck?
He only diet coke.
So she ordered her food. I ordered a bunch of sides because they ain't got shit for me there. But he was willing to make something special for me, but I didn't want to inconvenience the chef back there.
How you can be like mashed potatoes with some cheese in?
No, I had scallops, some kind of. 4 cheese scallop potatoes, they had some type of spinach there. Hold on, first of all, I got scallop potatoes with like 4 different types of cheeses on it. I got what's those baby cabbages, the cabbages or something like this.
Oh, Brussels
sprouts. Yeah, Brussels sprouts. I got some fancy.
Totally different.
I got some fancy.
Sorry,
Brussels sprouts. Kiss my
ass. I'm trying to function officially.
I got some fancy ass Brussels sprouts. I got something else, and I got this spinach.
Thank you, too.
Nigga, I have never had spinach. What's fucking delicious?
Oh,
I was about to say.
When I tell you, it wasn't even the thing. The spinach had cheese on it.
Yeah.
But it was. I don't know.
Like a spinach and artichoke.
I don't know what. No, it was just spinach, but it had like a sauce on it. No idea what the sauce was.
It had some cheese in it.
It must have. It was like liquid crap.
Yeah.
Okay. But nigga, I was like, that spinach is the best thing I've had. The best vegetable I've had. Probably and I'm a broccoli king and shit. And then she ordered like a whole bunch of fancy raw shit.
Fancy raw shit.
Sushi and shit like that.
Ah, fuck. But nigga, when I tell you while she was eating, the look of pure satisfaction.
I ain't never seen this in your face. That's exactly what I said.
Oh my God. Dude. I'm gonna be pushing.
I ain't getting up
with.
Nigga.
Yeah, cream
spinach.
That's what it is, Virginia.
Baby coming soon.
Nigga, when I the look on her face, nigga, I was looking. The look of pure satisfaction. I fucked you pretty good. I've never seen that look on your face before. I've never done that.
Hold on, that's a taste up.
It's another face besides the face you thought was the face.
I'm still down here, but
cream spinach is up
here. Raw steak and raw. Come on, like nigga, fucking.
He said sushi and sashimi got you.
You said that mushu.
I was mushu like, park, this, man. This shit, oh, that shit was fucking awful. What? I think either that day or the next day, I found this movie on YouTube about. It's called Run, Hide, Fight. If anybody want to watch it, it's on YouTube right now for free. That. It's called Run, Hide, Fight. It's about some motherfuckers taking over a school, killing a bunch of folks. If you just want a movie it's good, but you're going to spend your time yelling at the TV like, what the fuck are you doing? This is one of the movies. It's worth your time and shit.
Or you can watch Rampage. That's more like American.
This movie is American. What are you talking about?
You never seen Rampage?
No. Oh, man. The game?
No, it's like... No, it's about like... motherfucker getting like armor, guns, and killing the whole city. Going on a killing spree.
Little crazy guy.
It's like three... it's like three movies. Yeah. That was at your crew. He was watching that. Remember, I was right there.
He's like a teenager.
I probably got...
He got armor. He got a whole bunch of... Yeah,
he built a whole armor suit, yep, like buying shit from Amazon, off the
internet. I probably got on the PS3.
Blew up the whole goddamn police station.
On actual Valentine's Day, we woke up. I told her that no matter what, Nick, we started this day off with Cracker Barrel pancakes for me. What? You can have something for me. I got me some blueberry pancakes. I got me some blueberry pancakes. We ate breakfast at Cracker Barrel. That shit was delicious. We did a bunch of other shit after that.
So you went there and got your ass whipped.
That's exactly what Cracker Barrel means.
Hey, man. We know what Cracker Barrel is. And that breakfast ain't racist. I don't care. That breakfast
was made by slaves and handed down by slaves.
Well, I think some of my ancestors ain't paying the name of shit. That hash brown casserole?
Here we go. I was like, slave ain't made that.
Wow. Take your pride out.
About to say, even no slaves at all.
That was the biracials.
Jesus Christ. So that was my Valentine's Day. Two day Valentine's Day.
Nice.
Definitely did my job. Definitely was satisfied. Ended off with some
Well, take it to the head.
As it should. And now you can't run no more. Single nigga.
What the single nigga do?
What you right,
talking about the good lies.
He said, my hair, talking about the good girl. We met up in the middle.
So look. All right, right. I went to the store, you know.
Man, ain't nobody getting that McBitchin, girl. Still.
So look. I got, the store had two ribeyes in the shape of a heart because they were connected together. Right?
So I got butterfly in your pretty
much. Yeah, basically butterfly. No, but it was two though. It was two. Yeah,
I feel like I saw that on TikTok and shit. It was very lonely.
I was like, go ahead.
Disrespect.
So I pan-seared them, you know. put them on my grill skillet, you know, got them good, got them right. Did some shrimp, some roasted potatoes, you know.
Hey, time out. You did not put this on Snapchat. I didn't. So guess what? It must have been a really lonely night. He Snapchat everything.
Hey, yo, you're dumb to me, bro.
Bro, live your best life. Put that shit up.
Hey, I'll be quiet. I'm just listening.
All right. Those are the days. So I make that.
Hold on. You're going to say that's why you engaged?
Look here.
Ain't no going back.
Are you trying to say ain't no going back to the good days? Is that what I'm hearing?
No. Ain't no going back to the single life.
But no,
it's
said,
over.
Oh, the good days, it ain't no going back. All right.
Nah, I was helping you. You're fucking
right.
Look,
hey, you're not doing the dark side.
Right. All right, so look. So, you know, I plated it up for me and Bae, you know what I'm saying? Like, whoop-de-whoop-de-whoop. We ate, and then I woke up like, oh, damn, that was a dream.
No, I'm kidding. I'm about to say, nigga, what?
No.
They was horrible days.
Days.
It wasn't great.
Days. You put an IES on that. Days.
It was horrible days.
Hey, did you look? It got a little warm. Just my
Fuck you, Marcus.
She said work. Oh shit.
Oh, you late?
I really am. I really am. I was looking at a different comment. I'm sorry.
Oh.
Wait a minute.
But so like so. I made the steaks or whatever, and then like I set one aside for lunch today. I mean for dinner that night, and I set one aside for lunch that morning.
They know.
I had one for dinner. I had one for dinner. I set the other half of the heart shaped steak. The heart shaped steak. It was two ribeyes. You guys, you can look them up.
I know. I can't. You didn't post it.
You're right.
It was, they had a whole case full of them.
But how do you put the steaks together?
So when you got
glue?
No. Okay, so look.
Hey, that's a real thing.
No, so the way steaks work.
How do steaks work?
But it come in a whole loaf. The whole thing. They cut like two sections worth, and they cut that two sections, they butterfly the two sections, so it falls apart like that, and it kind of shaped like a heart. So that's how you end up.
Why you didn't share it?
I don't know. I just didn't. I was like, these people are all in love. They don't need to see me in my lonely state tonight.
Oh, man. You know what? I got to greet these two right here now.
What? I mean, it wasn't bad, but I mean, it wasn't great. No. Because I look. So, all right. So, speaking of my brother. So, it's Sunday night. I'm asleep, right?
Anyone to bring him up? I just wanted to. Before you make that transition. Right? Okay, cool. I just wanted to make sure.
He's like, you ain't share with your brother?
Yeah.
So,
you got steak by yourself.
I'm asleep, right? All I hear is, I'm like,
that should just sound more lonely, though.
It did, didn't it? here come my brother walking up to the door, and he door dashed. And I'm like, and he come walking back past.
Oh, you asleep. So,
fuck you.
All right. I got to sleep. Got me some steaks.
You want
to play rough?
All right. All right. So here's the question. Why would you by yourself?
All right, so I'm by myself.
It's somebody that you're interested in that we know of.
What is happening?
That y'all know of. I know nothing about this.
Huh? What is happening? This is minute.
I'm being the dinosaur.
It's only minute 23 minutes. I don't know. It's only 23 minutes we've been going. What'd you say?
What is the time? What is it?
Ooh, it's 9:30. Y'all ain't got to work in the morning?
No.
No? Oh, I got to work in the morning. Well, all right, y'all. I'm going to head over that.
Trying to cut out and shit. No, I'm not going to work this.
What was the question?
Why would you buy yourself?
You ever had homemade vodka from Austin, Texas?
Don't endorse this nigga trying to get out the. Why would you buy yourself,
Mike? Because I am a single gentleman.
My choice?
Yeah.
So you heard the question. You heard it.
He's looking for Mrs. Wright.
Right.
Yes, you ain't got to. She could be right.
Not now. The right hoe.
I mean, that's a tough question to
just not
into. But no, I mean, like, I'm out here. I'm just chilling.
That sounded horrible. Like a whore.
Oh.
Are you a whore, man?
I'm not a whore. Definitely not a whore.
Hey.
But you just saying I'm out here, man.
It's getting hot, man.
That's swear to you, Joe's the word.
But nah, I'm single. I am mingling, ladies. Feel free to look me up.
Like most whores.
I am not a whore. I am just enjoying my single life as a 31-year-old man with
no kids.
Good job, and no kids, and two businesses, and
this ain't Tinder. Hey,
put the
heart.
He put in his resume now.
Put your stock portfolio on.
Hey,
there too.
Man, look, hey.
Well,
he just lost $30,000 of of GameStop stuff.
Oh, he was on
the
don't
believe lies. Don't believe the lies. But no, yeah, I'm single, and it's by choice. I heard two of the. Yeah, cooks for your girls. I can definitely cook. I mean, like I can cook. I throw down in the kitchen.
He just ain't got nobody to throw down with.
I can send.
You're confused. You heard all of us bought food for our girl.
No,
I bought food. He bought food.
Well, him and his girl.
He cooked. His fiance. He cooked for himself.
I didn't cook. She cooked. This time. She cooked.
So what did you do? I'm being honest with you.
What you mean? It was a joint effort.
It was Valentine for each other.
All right.
I feel like hers is more than yours.
Oh my god. You know what?
Bought me some stuff. I did get a massage. Okay. That shit was great.
I feel like she did more too.
Not you.
No, baby, no.
First of all, she was shopping with me.
Anyway, baby, no, that's just for real.
No.
If we were single, we'd be using the microwave.
Why you gotta point over here, bro?
Actually, you're single.
I mean, but like, I cook more than all three of y'all put together.
Wow. No, you cook more. But not all of us put together. Bro. I cook more than these motherfuckers don't.
Exactly. Cook. If they don't cook, and I cook more than you.
You don't cook?
I got an air fryer now. So
He don't cook.
No, nigga, that count.
They don't cook.
You can make a full meal in the air fryer. Right.
Fuck, not even look at it.
But the air fryer is not
okay. You season that shit, you throw it in the air fryer, beat that shit good.
Listen, you see that?
The air fryer beats all the work.
If I walk in a restaurant and it's an air fryer there, I'm walking out.
I can do this shit myself. Hey,
exactly.
What am I paying for?
I got an Instapot. I know. Y'all ain't got an Instapot.
You say I know that nigga.
Get your ass from behind,
nigga.
Family
right there with Instapot. Got the rice on the bottom. Got the chicken in the middle. Get out there.
Soon as I walk in a restaurant, all I hear from the back is, hey!
You make people out here cooking smarter than hard?
Okay. Okay, Google. Fried mushrooms. No shit, just not working by itself.
I know, right? Push two buttons. It got pictures on it.
Yeah. I thought my shit's gonna go off. Legit, yep. I was like,
Franco's favorite meal. Shit. Blink two.
Insert one cup of uncooked rice.
Legit. That's like 4 minutes.
The air fryer and the Instapot.
Hell no, you better lean over that pot and watch it.
Burn up, please. This nigga's out there with two air fryers right next to each other. This one for the chicken, this one for the fries. Put them in at the same time and go on about your business, nigga.
Cooking
ain't cooking though.
Look, hold on. Legit, it's a whole ass business opened up down the street with them air fryers, dog.
But look, they make their sauces, though. I ain't gonna say nothing.
Sauce ain't nothing.
They make the sauce, though.
But you know what I'm talking about, though.
It's fire.
Why it took me down there, like, bro?
I put them on.
And then I went on.
He saw the truth.
I'm like, all these niggas out here just
air frying it up.
Air frying it up.
They sausage all day.
Don't knock they hustle. I support y'all. I ain't gonna say y'all name though, but I support y'all.
I support y'all too, cause that.
I was wondering, what is you leaving in the point that, nigga? You pointing at my? They can't see us over here.
I heard somebody say they couldn't hear me, so I had to get up in here and point at their ass. Like, I know you hear me, motherfucker.
Yeah, she was a cook.
First of all,
before she was a
point up retarded.
No, no, no. I'm pointing. In all directions.
He pointed in two directions and said, I'm pointing in all directions.
I said, no, no, no.
You and ain't seen it. And I then, said, no, it. No, and then that's when you realize, like, oh, wait, I only pointed in two directions.
I had to do it twice. And then I did it all twice. Whoa. Whoa. No, no homo.
I'm speaking from this motherfucker.
I had to take from this so this nigga wouldn't be distracted from answering questions.
You're right.
You're right.
You're right.
Oh, damn.
For real, man?
Say, what's up with the fries? I mean,
no, no, no. Go underneath that table, bro. What y'all, what y'all doing?
Yeah. I was good for 16 years before I was a CNA.
Okay,
I'll
be saying that.
Yay, yeah, yay. Yeah.
All right, baby. We might have to cook something up together.
You love being a cook to be a CNA? Girl, we got to talk about your life decisions. I feel like you leave CNA to become a cook and shit, but that's a whole different story.
Well, we off topic.
Yeah, that first one was the topic, motherfucker. Okay. I just want to see what y'all did for Valentine's Day.
Oh, okay.
The general topic. Is that saying you just drink?
His whole glass is
full.
No, it's
the
third one.
Oh, that was like a minute ago, bro.
Yeah, we're ready to talk, and we got to talk.
Excuses are building blocks and nothing different.
You know what? You took yours, so it's got a little hot for you.
Hey, well,
you right about that.
Shout out to Roslyn.
Roslyn Dazzy.
Pinkies out.
She ain't watching this shit no more.
She left.
She was she at home playing with your wife?
Wow.
Whoa, she at home playing with your
wife. No. No.
He said, you think I would be here doing a podcast?
Blinds.
No, they in a nice neighborhood. No, so you have to follow suit. That's what they do.
Get blinds?
Mm-hmm. No, that's also how people get kidnapped and raped, too.
No, that's why they get shot.
Wait, how?
How is it?
They see you by yourself.
Through blinds?
Through
blinds.
That's crack.
Trying to come to curtains.
Oh, okay. Because, you know, in the morning they have their shit wide open.
Oh, you.
And that's shit.
Oh, you want to know that?
Yeah,
that family?
Yes.
Shit. No, you ain't there. You at work. I still lock my doors. When y'all be coming over for parties, y'all niggas got to knock on the door before y'all even come to the door.
That's right.
I don't give a fuck about none of that.
Hell yeah.
If I knock on the door, call me. You ain't getting to my house without me.
Everybody jump on vibrate.
I got to answer this, y'all.
Side Chick Saturday.
No.
It's a whole Friday.
You right.
You know what pissed me off about that, though? My girl is one of the people, and I hate it.
What?
One of the people who like all the windows open and shit.
Ooh.
I hate that shit.
Hey, chill out, Benny. Don't do that. We ain't even did nothing to you.
I'm telling y'all more. See, no, the last two times you said that shit, we didn't call hella snow.
All kind of snow.
And you know what?
I'm about to send rabbit puppies your way. How about that?
Yeah. It's going to be raining rabbit, cats, and dogs.
See, what's that? New York?
Yeah.
All right. They get
some
shit too.
That shouldn't happen. They get
remember Superstorm Sandy?
They get our shit first, motherfucker.
Hey, yo, fuck y'all, man.
What?
Y'all already know y'all got an answer for Mom Dukes.
Oh, yeah.
Why would your mama know that?
She ain't fucking about
him. He don't say nobody
never. Ain't nobody never saved this new phone.
That's some playing stuff, all right.
That's good.
Wow. Hey, you know what? Fuck the topic we talking about. We're talking about this nigga now. I ain't about to shit this nigga now.
That nigga tripping.
This nigga tripping.
We not about to put, we still on Beyonce's internet?
We are definitely. We're gonna put him on blast. We're just gonna ask some questions.
Nah,
we gotta ask him. This is not that kind of interview.
I love you, bro.
That's what she's on with.
We you have another 8 inches.
Fuck. Ain't you supposed to be on a business trip to Ohio? Hmm?
You ain't gotta answer that.
I mean, invention, it's really a business talent show.
It really is. That's all you gotta say. Yes.
He tried to spin that shit a while.
Look, he drinking.
Hey, look, hold on. He tried. First off, he tried to spin it open. But I gotta have somebody to ask it to. I got nobody to ask it to.
He sounds kind of defensive.
He does sound defensive.
It was attacking.
What? Wow.
All I did was ask him
a business trip. All he had to say was, yeah.
No. He said, don't you have a business trip to take to Ohio?
Do you?
I mean, what? I'm like, we get over this.
Hey, my brother said the empathy shit. Like,
look, he lost.
Like,
Brandon lost himself.
What's the real?
I have nothing to do with what's going on right now.
You gotta ask him a question. He can act all defensive and shit.
Ain't nothing to be defensive about.
He said,
give me a Lincoln Murphy's.
Huh? That's what I'm asking, dog. Yeah, I got a business trip.
The way you said that was, the way you said that was hella suspect, though. Huh? Even when you don't, you look like you got something to hide.
Always. Been a gift and a curse my whole life.
It
was supposed to. Jesus.
Alright, let's
get it went up a little bit. I must be
alright, let's get to the topic or the scenario. Let's get into the scenario. Bam 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 bam.
You
say the NFL?
What
the fuck was that?
They will.
That wasn't even the NFL tune. They own the corporation and everything.
I got express written consent.
You a damn liar.
From my mama.
See your ass to earth.
But Bubba said it anyway.
Wow. All right, so here go the situation. Let's say I'm going to give it to you two different ways. Let's say you are on a date with a young lady.
Mm-hmm.
First date. And you expect it to be you and her.
Okay.
And she shows up with two other female friends.
Oh.
Are you obligated to pay?
I gotta use the bathroom.
are you obligated to pay for those two other friends that she's
go first. I'm gonna go first. This date has ended as soon as you bring other people to our date. If I'm interested in you, I'm not interested in two other bitches you bring with you.
Right. They ain't gotta be all that.
Right.
But my first date, you bring you and two of your friends, I get that. Like, y'all wanna be make sure the nigga good and all that. They could be somewhere else.
Yeah, y'all can be at the table by yourself.
I could be at the table somewhere else.
Factual. But
you ain't gotta be with table, us. We meet up at the restaurant. She like, hey, my girls came with me, they're gonna be over there because you know what I'm saying, it's the first date, a lot of they might have skipped. All right, I respect that because, you know, females nowadays, niggas are crazy. You never know.
Facts.
But if they come in, they're like, oh, yeah, we're going to get the table for four instead of the table for two? Nah.
I'm
good.
I'm about to say.
You can have dinner with them.
Now easy always.
I'm going to go first. I'm going to go second. So, like, if I sit down at the table and then you and your two friends, y'all sit down. If they cute, I'm gonna be like, so y'all trying to put me on the floor, or what are we discussing here?
Is it single me with
like you really
is that the situation? I thought
we had something more than that, but I mean like if y'all just want to like have y'all way as long as it ain't no crazy, you know? Cause yeah, no, thank you. Exit only. But in real life,
legit.
Just a little bit. But no, real talk, no, I would be like, I would have to ask her. I would have to be like, I would break it down like specifically. I would tell her like 100% understand why they're here because you don't really know me like that. I don't know you like that. I got dudes outside with guns.
Wait, what?
Y'all, okay, anyway.
I would
definitely like ask her seriously, like I understand why they're here. And I mean, because you don't know me, and I don't know you like that. But at the same time, nigga, you should have put it behind you.
Dumbass, I know, right?
Get the charger.
Get the charger up.
Get the charger.
And it's on camera, which you just fumble.
Fumble? I never reached for
he
it.
He turned around in the circle.
Because he knocked me around. I didn't go in the circle on my own. He knocked me around.
All right, come on. Finish your story.
No, all right. So I would definitely, like, bring it to her attention, like, how it appears. Like, look, okay, I understand why they're here, but is it possible for them to get a separate table off to the side? You know, I would ask her first and tell her, like, no, I was 100% intended on paying for our date because this is our date. This is not their date, you know? And if she had any objections against that, all right, I understand. I mean, I would have loved to have a great time with you tonight, but I'm gonna have to go. I'm not just gonna call it off right there and walk out. But also, I'm not gonna just sit there and pay for three women's dates when I'm only really on a date with one of them. Right. Unless they're trying to put me on the
phone. They're trying to get a free meal out of your
business. I know, right?
Yeah. They try, like, you like boo boo the food.
Exactly. Like, I got one.
I know it's
boo boo the food. I was born in the morning. I know. But it wasn't this morning, man.
That's what they be skimming.
And the other side of the coin is
they're trying to get a Birkin bag out of you. Three of them.
Exactly. You know, like, even after a couple dates, if she was like, hey, you know, my girls want to meet you, blah, 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 skip, I might be feeling generous that night and pay for the whole table. Really? You know? I mean, that happens. That can happen. I've done that before. You know?
Don't be surprised if all three of them ask for a Birkin bag.
Oh, no. You know, new Birkin bags is like 40 grand each?
Nope.
Like, baby, do you want me to have a house and a car? I go to the bar shop and get you a Birkin bag.
I would die on the ground right there.
All right. What's your take, Wayne? Y'all turn out.
Y'all said everything. Hello, friends. My name's Dwayne. I will not be
y'all sugar daddy
investing in y'all meal.
Hey, y'all see that? He clutched his pearls. He was like, I will not.
Yes, my dreads are twisted. I paid for this. But I won't be paying for y'all meals. I paid for the one I was.
You see how he had to throw that in? Yeah, let's do what was happening in front of him. Right.
I'm pretty sure y'all are lovely people. You know, I got friends.
Facts.
And second to what he said, if y'all try to come pro,
well,
it's single me talking. Hey. Single me talking. Not now me talking.
Not him talking.
Come pro. You know what? Okay, let's go.
Well,
but
let's get a Red Bull meal. Let's get a Red Bull meal.
Y'all gotta go, hoes. Yeah, so that's how it goes.
Like, look, I don't know what y'all think, but this is horrible. I don't know what type of man y'all take me for.
Would you like some grape juice?
I'll pay for that. Jesus Christ.
We
stop the gas
baby.
Station.
Not gonna ask, what places you at where they serve grape juice?
Yeah. I don't know. I'm kidding. I'm hoping that they serve grape juice for these childish ass people that you
well,
I think the grape juice comes with bibs.
And the color and the crayons and the little bag.
Yeah. With the little maze.
From one into the other. And they just be scribbling. All kids just be scribbling all. I ain't never seen one single kid actually do the thing.
Right.
Come on. Unless you show you all
right, that type of
oh, y'all said everything that I was
okay.
on the first day tip. Okay, I'm more. You stayed here for too long. I wouldn't have got up and left. So this is pretty much over then. What you said?
Yeah, but we all went. You said what now?
You said
right.
Who? To what now?
You said Garcon, three bottles.
It's different. I say
I'm more of a. I will be right back.
He one of those niggas to be at work. I'm going to the bathroom.
Yeah.
Now they're clocking the fuck out and never coming back again.
That's one of them.
Better believe it.
All four of us, we have an amazing meal. I chop it up with them. I got them all laughing. I'm like, all right, look, hold on. I'm gonna run to the bathroom real quick. I'm gonna be right back.
Oh, leave them with the bill.
Well, they got three of them to split.
Wing.
That's not a bad
idea.
And they're gonna be like, the guy that went to the bathroom said y'all was splitting this three ways.
The nigga that just left?
Yeah. He jumped in his whip. He pulled up. He said y'all was splitting it three ways. So I gave y'all cash already.
Or like if you go somewhere, you know the waiter or the waitress. Right. Like, hey,
he said he had five on it.
But he said he got me when we get to the crib. back in the park.
So I'm at everybody to start reading. Same time.
Damn, that's a paragraph.
That's y'all. I'm really not reading.
But so that's a little different, Jessica. What Jessica said is, I don't think so. But last week I was supposed to go to lunch with two friends from work. But my husband and I just had a late lunch. But I still went to hang out. And since my husband was with me and driving, he came too, and he paid for their meals and our milkshakes. That was me and him ordered. That's what me and him ordered.
But now that's your husband.
Yeah. That's the second part of this question though, because it was like. It's all right, now it's different. You're in a relationship with the chick, you're in a relationship with a girl, let's say five years in. Let's say y'all having lunch, and then her, let's say two of her friends happen to come in, and she invite them to join y'all for lunch or whatever. Do you pay for all of them?
All right, let me go first.
I still need to be in that situation.
All right, all depends on what the fuck they order.
Exactly.
If they know our financial situation and they like, oh, I'm
trying to take advantage.
They're gonna order some shit that they know they can't afford, and I know they can't afford it. And I'm like, these hoes think I'm about
to. Can we get steak and lobster and put one of them steaks in the to-go thing?
Give me an extra lobster.
If we've been together for 5 years, I know them, they know me, and obviously my wife, they know our financial situation.
You're welcome, Betty.
They assume.
Right.
They assume
you gonna get that bill for
them. We gonna pick the bill and they order shit that I know they can't afford.
You gonna give them that look and like
I'm gonna hit them with the oh hell no. And then my wife's like hey, give me that nudge or like send me a text through it like, hey man, I know they can't afford it, but please take care. I might take care of it because they like my wife would tell me something like that.
Right.
But if it's like they are like they show up, we chilling. And then I'm like, hold on, these hoes ordering some shit. That, and they drinking good. And I know these bitches ain't got no money. It ain't gonna be on me. Woo. And it ain't gonna be on me.
All right. So, for me, you've been together 5 years, like you said. So, obviously, I'm more than likely to know these friends.
Right.
And it's probably been plenty of times where my wife has paid for their meals, and they might have paid for my wife's meals, and like at that
that's
point,
their dynamic.
Yeah, exactly. That's their dynamic, and at that point, more than likely, my money is her money is my money. Our funds are commingled, as we like to say in the
right.
So at that point, he said, you can't spell we without you and I. but y'all been together and like they probably have a dynamic as it is. So I would probably offer to pay just off Jump Street. Like, there would be some stipulations. Like, if they was just out here balling off out of control. Yeah, now, it's two things, though. Now, if they was buying stuff and they didn't expect me to pay, I might
you
still
tell,
pay.
But you could tell. You could tell. You could tell, like, people just buying, they, like, regular lunch shit. Somebody like we at lunchtime, it's 12 o'clock in the afternoon, they we stay locked.
Exactly.
And basically right. I'm like, but no, I know you work.
Me. Get a burger. Get a burger.
I'm like, I know you work at
these sliders, they don't say it.
They're like, fuck the lunch menu, I'ma order off the dinner menu exactly. And it's
when
still they, lunchtime with the fucking happy hour shit going
when they,
on.
They make okay. Little, like is Bruce still back there behind the counter? Because you tell him I want the Michelle regular with the...
the Michelle regular.
I look, man, some would take advantage of them because they know y'all financial situation.
But no, like...
Some people will, some people won't.
But it's been times
you know what?
Before when I've paid for a table.
Man, it was just like... Just had a flashback, yeah. Man.
You know what? You think about shit.
I did. I'm like...
But no, like, it's been times where... You know, I might choose to okay once the bill come around. Like, look, when wait, how many bills is it? Hey, look, I'm gonna get everybody except their drinks. They can get their own drinks. I've done that before. I mean, and that's something simple that you know, like just pay for the food, pay for everybody's food. They can handle their own drinks. That's all them. You know what I'm saying? Like, look,
I've done that before.
Exactly. You know, I mean, that's something simple. And I've done it the opposite of the way around. I've been at the bar and be like, look, hey, how your drinks on me? You know,
but. I do like a round on me. I'm not doing everybody drinks on me. Like,
it might be one specific person, your drinks on me. Like,
right.
If we there together, like, look, get whatever you want. But I know you ain't about to just, like,
straight up take crazy.
Exactly. And it's all about knowing the person, too. Like, you know, whether either situation, like, whether you're on a first date or a 30 date with a woman, you know, like, you can go to a bar and be like, all right, and tell your waitress, like, look, whatever she got, it's on me. Absolutely, Erdell. Erdell said, if we're at home and we order takeout with company over, we pay.
Yeah.
Absolutely.
Oh yeah.
But that's different.
We bring food to the house.
But we
y'all
always,
want something?
We always offer something. To pitch in.
Absolutely.
Sometimes don't even think about offering. Exactly. They just assume you're gonna initially pick up the bill because they know you got it.
And
they assume you got it.
And
you know they don't got it. Or they just don't wanna give it up.
Facts.
They just cheat. They're like, you know, they got fucking, they geared up. They geared up.
And then
that won't come out their pocket for shit. Want to drink off you. Want to eat off you.
This the work clothes side over here, man.
All those people like that. Like,
but that's legit.
They be geared up. They got the freshest gear on. Mm-hmm. But then they ask me. We're like, yeah.
You
like,
got me?
We going to the bar or going to get some food. Like, yeah, we all order food. They're like, oh,
that's
you got
true.
Me? You got me? No, nigga, I got you.
Like, look,
you
a
whole bar. You're drinking.
Exactly. And then you go
sell
to the bar.
Sell a shoe.
Right.
Just one.
Sell a shoe. They go to the bar after this scenario. They go to the bar. Now they want to buy shots for everybody. Oh. Buy shots for everybody. Like, hold on, nigga. What you mean?
So you only have food?
Yeah,
you
have food.
Drink. But you got drink money?
For these hoes, huh?
See, look, that's because, you know, my wife got two halves. She got the drink side. She got the for the whole side and it's for the stomach. You know, that was spinning out the one side. And that's legit, too. I mean, it's all about the understanding, honestly. Yep. Like, it's been times I've been out with family where I offered to pay for everybody, you know what I mean? It's all about the situation. I really feel like every situation, when it comes to this, is a little different. Because, like...
Kendrick is showing his hypocrisy, because now he has a good-paying job.
I always had a good-paying job.
And
besides BK and all the other shit.
Now he has a good paying job.
Hold on.
First of all,
I was with you.
The reason why I don't pay for to have money. This is before you came around.
Yeah.
This is before we started eating breakfast.
So
this is straight on Kendall, Q.
He right though.
Tamante.
100%. He right as hell. Like, cause we was all like some cheap ass niggas, broke as fuck.
I had to pay for these motherfuckers because we was at Old Country Buffet.
Yes.
Cheapest shit in the world.
Cheapest shit in the world.
I had to pay for these three motherfuckers to come eat on my birthday.
You're right.
That was the last year I ever tried to even celebrate my birthday ever in life. They killed it for me.
100%.
I don't like celebrating my birthday.
He legit.
I don't ever celebrate my birthday. I pay for people on my birthday. Now I'm thinking about it.
No, it was that and it was I know a set of twin, so when females, we were just talking about them.
Ooh, did you go to their birthday
party? We went to their birthday party. And somehow the bill ended up on me.
Definitely that. I was there. I know where it was at too.
Do I know these?
Yeah.
Do I know these set of twins?
Yes.
She said the feed. Nigga. She said the feed that
girl. We was I think I know what you're talking about.
Better now.
Alright, I'm gonna shut up.
So
take better.
Yes, I remember that because he brought me with. He brought me.
Oh, let me finish. Because basically, they had a birthday party. This is when they was going to.
She said the feed.
This is basically when
we went there, Dale.
This is when
I was there. Oh, where?
They went to school. They went to school at U of M Flint.
I know exactly.
This is when we was all hanging around.
I knew this.
Who went there?
I just said him wasn't there, nigga.
Yeah,
so anyway,
we
got invited to their birthday party. A bunch of motherfuckers went. The only people that I know there are the twins.
True that. I pulled them out.
All right. I didn't even order that.
You ordered nothing.
I ordered nothing.
We sat there.
We were just sitting there chilling, talking shit.
They come up to this nigga.
Somehow the bill made its way to me. Out of all these people here,
the bill made its way to me.
They were like, ain't you gonna pay for me? It's my birthday. I'm all like, I'm sitting here like,
I'm looking like, what the fuck is going on here, nigga?
I'm like, okay, all right, it's their birthday. Let me not act like me on their birday in front of all these people.
We was at a restaurant.
I was just like, you know what? I was like, what?
I was confused as hell.
But I never went out with them again. They never invited me to. And plus, I never celebrated nobody's birthday after that. Fuck y'all birthdays. Fuck mine while we had it.
Was not for my birthday.
Huh?
It was not for my birthday last year.
Nigga. No, I wasn't.
Yes, you were.
Which one?
At Pickers. You was throwing ones.
Yeah, yes.
I feel like I'm more showed up to that. I didn't kind of.
I don't know.
I will make it.
I will make an appearance.
I made an appearance, but I feel like that's not me celebrating. That's just me showing my face. Hey, fuck you, bye.
I mean, he was there. You came to her birthday dinner in 2019.
All y'all was in 2019.
I didn't.
I showed my
face. Did nobody show up and do shit yesterday, last year, man?
I know, right?
Well, last year.
Last year, no. My birthday. We still made my birthday last year.
Yeah, we went to Topgolf.
We went to Topgolf.
Yeah, that was cool.
That was dope, though.
Yeah, it really was.
I'm about to say, we need to go back. I didn't go to none of those.
It was like, I could only have 7 people in there in the stall.
Is that what it's called?
Yeah.
The stall. Yes, Ardell, you are correct.
She said
2019. Okay. He came to the dinner.
Where was the dinner? I don't even remember that.
I don't remember these things.
I'm sure I was there.
And I'm sure I didn't stay for long.
To the dinner? Who's dinner?
I didn't remember.
2019.
What'd you have?
See, I'm pretty sure he was there. He didn't remember me being there.
I'm sure
we had so much shit going on.
Go to that mall.
This whole
mall. What mall are you going to? And then there was silence. We was all just waiting for it.
I was
Yeah.
Buffalo Wild. Oh, yeah, I got pictures.
We did go to Buffalo Wild Wings. Damn. You really did show up.
You right.
Yeah, you was definitely there.
He stole one of my wings, and that bitch was too damn hot.
He was sweating.
I forgot about that.
That's
just making up, parents.
He was there the whole time. That's more than
me. He got there before everybody, remember?
He was early.
I pulled up, they're like, yeah, bring me here.
Oh, yeah. I thought I was late. Turned out I was early as fuck, which made me.
He was the first one there.
I was so pissed.
I pulled up like, what?
Note to self, always tell Brandon it's an hour early.
I looked at my clock, I'm like,
that was my thing. I'm sitting there like,
all of them? All the Buffalo Wild Wings? That's crazy.
I was planning on.
In New York, though? That's where it started, right?
I don't think it is.
Buffalo, New York.
Buffalo, New York. That's where the Buffalo. That's where Buffalo Wings started. I don't know.
Oh my god. My plan was just my plan to all y'all shit is just I show up late, I make an appearance, and then I break out and shit. I showed up and somehow I was just here early before you. I'm like, what the fuck?
Yeah, it was weird, man.
Everybody was late. Shire got there first and he got there second. Did y'all ride with me that day? I feel like somebody rode with me that day.
I think.
Did y'all know we still don't get along?
That's not the time.
On Beyonce,
we don't talk about none of that.
Take a shot for me.
Rise to your neck is a shot that. That's shoulders.
To the shoulder. Knees and toes.
Right.
There we go.
I should not drink this. I have to work in. I gotta work in the morning.
Man, what the fuck? We've had to work the last couple mornings.
Man,
which I don't know why I am. I like to be at work because I actually have to work.
I actually had to work this motherfucker.
Every time your camera,
every time his phone vibrates, so does the camera.
So your phone vibrates because you got to connect it to the thing.
Oh, probably. You be alright.
So put that on silent.
It ain't showing. It's on silent.
You know, silent or is it on vibrate?
It's probably on vibrate.
Yeah. That shit on silent. Y'all can see me getting close. Hey. Get silly.
I guess silly.
You have to fix the camera. This is about to be over, nigga. It's over an hour.
At the end of the shit, got your video. I'm pretty sure you got a video for us.
Of what?
I don't know. Of anything.
Do you not want to go home? Our deal's watching.
Somebody.
Oh, look, we ain't got
you time. Got a video of somebody dying or something.
Jesus Christ. What the fuck?
Look, I just know you do.
What more?
Somewhere in the safe. Jesus. Reach in there somewhere. Close your eyes and just pick.
Definitely a blind moment. Brandon's not blind.
He dyes his hair. I thought about it. He actually is. This is just for me. I'm actually 65. Just for me. Father Time. Father Time. BTW. I got mad all over. Our safe. That's what's up. That's good. Shout out to my family. Shout out to everybody in Texas. I'm still mad at what you said. Not everybody, but most of them. Why are you playing with that? Fucking,
We need to get some fidget spinners.
Right, they.
They've been sitting there.
First of all, you lied, nigga. You said people in Texas didn't have no generators. A lot of people got generators.
My people don't have no generators.
That's what I said, but you made it sound like you couldn't get a generator in Texas.
You probably could. You pay for that shit.
But all of them, you gotta pay for them.
But what's the odds of you needing a generator in Texas?
Hey, Ken.
Well, they get the hurricane.
Depends
how far you inland.
But like, so like,
boy, they still get the floods and shit. That fuck
they too inland to get that. Like Houston, Houston, where your people at?
Houston, Houston get the floods.
Yes, where your people at?
Yeah.
Where my people at? Nah, they don't get none of that.
My
homeboy, they too far. No, they too inland. No, they too inland. They don't get none of that.
So, my homeboy.
Yeah, they inland. They still catching these rolling blackouts. Get a generator.
If this don't teach y'all anything,
power's on now.
Teach y'all
they good today.
Like my whole like
4 days.
OC in Houston. His power went out, and his power came back on, but his water still been out. Cause like they local pump stations completely frozen. They got power, but either all the pipes are burst or frozen solid.
Definitely that.
Yeah.
That shit's so funny. I seen it ain't really funny. But it's fucked up because, like, I looked it on.
What I posted was hilariously fucked up.
When the chick was on the TikTok, she's like, yeah, she had a song playing and shit. And the next thing I was like, her car covered in ice.
She saw the whole parking lot.
The parking lot. It hurt. She the only car in the parking lot.
She like, it's seven floors to this parking lot.
And she the only one.
And she's like, she saw the parking lot. She's like, it's seven floors to this parking lot. Her car. She's like, why is this my car? It's car. one pipe burst above her car and it's frozen solid. Her car
is frozen.
She needed an axe to get in her car.
Get the fuck out.
I'm like, that's crazy.
I seen that. I think I seen that.
Lower than that, Betty. Like, I woke up the other morning and it was like nine. It was -9 outside.
It was -19 on the way to work.
Facts. Yeah. And I was like, why? So like,
why am I going?
That morning, I rolled over. I grabbed my keys because I keep a spare set of keys by my bed, and I hit the remote start just right there. It was like 45 minutes before I had to be to work. But I rolled over and I started to cry right there. And I was like,
they know. I had that bitch a couple more times, make sure it's eight more.
I don't remember what it was today.
Yes, he did.
Yeah, I did.
He said he didn't post that yet.
Yeah, he did. So, like, today the low was 16 and the high was 27.
That's crazy.
Yesterday, it was
but negative 19. Yeah, yesterday it was rough.
It was negative 19. I was like, what the fuck is this, bro?
Like, I don't ever wear coats, but I wear a coat on Wednesday. Yeah. Got it out the closet and was like, look.
It was cold then. I was late too.
Oh man, I walked up to work, right? I walked up. These motherfuckers out there shivering, smoking cigarettes outside the door. That's like, is that serious, huh?
You need that nigga team, huh?
Like, how come y'all not in the car?
Like, you gonna freeze it. Cause they gotta clock in and go to work. They go to freeze it, trying to get their last puff right before they fucking walk in the door.
And that tobacco.
Ooh, it's a motherfucker.
I'm like, ain't nothing that serious, bro. Like, I'm the fuck.
You know, it's always a faithful person outside somebody's truck at work.
Hey, faithfully. We got this one guy. I ain't gonna say his name, but that nigga stay in the, like, friend zone.
He friend zone.
When I tell you, it be cold as hell, right?
You need a whole friend zone line. She be in the car,
chilling. Like, she roll her window down. She in the truck, warm as hell. Never invite this nigga in the truck or nothing. Boy, he outside the car. He, one time, he spent his whole lunch break.
A blizzard.
One lunch break.
A blizzard.
Lunch break.
Cold.
30 minutes. It's cold as fuck.
Cold as fuck.
He out there shaking the shit. She out there talking, eating her food, and not... And
pass me the cigarette.
And not letting that motherfucker in the bro, I was like, it gotta be. Like, I don't know what... It gotta be, like, made out of gold. Ain't no female gonna ever have me stand outside.
Sunshine.
The cold. The cold like that. He out there smoking a cigarette. He smelled like a whole damn thing.
The last catch was outside no truck.
Hey, what?
For no vehicle.
What? Why? Well, look, man. Hey, man.
It's like every day, though.
You try to slick a can of oil. I don't know who you think you're
with. I'm telling you. We leave work, go to lunch. She come back from lunch. He intentionally tried to find her car where she parked it. Just to park.
They roll up.
And get out his car, his warm car. Go stand next to her and outside the coop and eat his food while he's talking to her.
Is he sliding?
No! Nowhere near! No!
Only on the ice?
Nowhere near!
I got some questions I'm going to ask after the show.
Nowhere near!
He's sliding. He think he's sliding.
This
he's
real shit, man. Every day, faithfully.
I'm gonna drink that, cause that nigga is tripping, dog.
Faithful. Outside that truck every day, every break. Don't play. Cigarette lit.
We see some gullible shit.
Legit.
Bro. I'm like, bro, like, it ain't that serious. Like,
never met anybody.
Y'all ain't gonna talk to him? Y'all ain't gonna give him
no advice? No, we talk to him. We be calling this nigga. But I tell you, he got a whole ass job. His job is to work the dock. The dock way.
Very familiar.
Where? Doc,
way on
the north end of the building. This motherfucker on the south end of the building. Talking to her. He got
on the line, though. Pull up, like, on the front yard and shit.
Like, he get off his high low.
Y'all don't be putting up my job, right? That's a job, right? Yeah.
This nigga get off the high low like he, like, don't have the nothing to do. It's like 4 or 5 trucks. I'm like, what the fuck is this nigga?
Right there.
I swear to God, we on the line yelling at the nigga, get your gay ass, get your bitch in, baby.
Man.
And then we get on, and he roll drive around slow. He's like, oh shit, I got trucks. And then he try to bust him out real fast. Like, get your goofy ass up.
The number one thing I always say to him to make him leave, because I make sure he hear me. I be like, she says you all truck, no dick.
Cause he got
this shit extended up high and he short too. So, well, yeah, big ass tires, big ass shoulders.
Oh, you talking about that? Yeah.
Oh no, he overcompensating. Well,
what the fuck about here? I got food waiting for me.
Oh, we do.
Somebody this has been another high.
Here, man.
Something about that salsa.
Let's get out your way.
Yeah, you know, let's go ahead.
This has been another episode of Bitching by the Bar.
By the Bar.
By the motherfucker.
Episode 7. Thank you all for
joining us. Number 7.
Bar Jason's.
Bitchin' Bar Jason.
Might be episode 7.
It is.
We hope it's 7. Lucky number 7.
Number 6. Is 7 in
Lucky number 11.
Wow. Wow. All movies, nigga.
Hey, look. It was right there.
I'll see you guys next Friday with a brand new episode. I am Frank with a Pen. This is Kendall B.
Woo!
Marky D.
Marky D in the place to be.
Wayne gets it in.
Yeah, I'm an OnlyFans. Woo! Prices are going up on Monday, $19.99 a month.
$115 now.
Y'all better get it now.
Prices real, baby.
We'll see you guys next Friday with a brand new episode of Bitch About the Bar.
Well, and we out of this thing.
Thanks for
don't trip. Either one of y'all.